Welcome to Sky Sea Channel, the channel that always discusses anything about the sea. In today's video, we are going to explore some of the most amazing and impressive vessels that are used to construct subsea infrastructure. These are the pipelaying vessels, or pipelayers for short. They are maritime vessels that serve to connect oil production platforms with refineries on shore by laying pipes between subsea structures. They also carry heavy lift cranes, used to install pumps and valves, and other equipment to support the pipelaying process. But how do they do it? And what are the biggest pipelaying vessels in the world? You won't believe how huge and powerful they are. Let's find out. How do pipelaying vessels work? There are different methods of pipelaying, depending on the type of pipe, the water depth, and the environmental conditions. The most common methods are J-lay, S-lay, reel-lay, and flex-lay. J-lay is a method where the pipe is lowered vertically from the vessel in a J-shaped curve until it reaches the seabed. This method is suitable for deep water and steep slopes, as it reduces the bending stress on the pipe. The pipe sections are welded together on board the vessel and then lowered by a tower or a crane. As you can see, the pipe is hanging from the tower like a giant fishing rod. Imagine how strong and stable the vessel must be to handle such a weight. S-lay is a method where the pipe is laid horizontally from the vessel in an S-shaped curve until it reaches the seabed. This method is suitable for shallow water and flat terrain, as it reduces the tension on the pipe. The pipe sections are welded together on board the vessel and then fed through a stinger, which is a rigid structure that supports the pipe as it leaves the vessel. Reel lay is a method where the pipe is spooled onto a large reel on board the vessel before being deployed. The pipe is then unspooled from the reel and straightened by a tensioner before being laid on the seabed. This method is suitable for small diameter pipes and long distances, as it reduces the welding time and cost. Flex lay is a method where the pipe is flexible and can be coiled or spooled onto a carousel or a drum on board the vessel before being deployed. The pipe is then uncoiled or unspooled from the carousel or drum and laid on the seabed. This method is suitable for complex subsea configurations and dynamic applications, as it allows for more maneuverability and adaptability. What are the biggest pipelaying vessels in the world? Now that we know how pipelaying vessels work, let's take a look at some of the biggest ones in the world. These vessels are capable of laying pipes in water depths of more than 2,500 meters or 8,200 feet and handling pipes with diameters of up to 60 inches or 1.5 meters. Solitaire. The Solitaire is one of the largest pipelaying vessels in the world. It is owned by Allseas Group, a Swiss-based offshore contractor. It was built in 1998 and converted from a crude oil tanker. It has a length of 300 meters or 984 feet and a width of 41 meters or 135 feet. It can accommodate up to 420 people on board. It uses the J-lay method and can lay pipes with diameters of up to 60 inches or 1.5 meters in water depths of up to 3,000 meters or 9,800 feet. It has a lifting capacity of 1,000 tons or 2.2 million pounds and can carry up to 22,000 tons or 48.5 million pounds of pipes on board. Audacia. The Audacia is another large pipelaying vessel in the world. It is owned by Allseas Group as well. It was built in 2007 and converted from a container ship. It has a length of 225 meters or 738 feet and a width of 32 meters or 105 feet. It can accommodate up to 320 people on board. It uses both J-lay and S-lay methods and can lay pipes with diameters of up to 48 inches or 1.2 meters in water depths of up to 3,000 meters or 9,800 feet. It has a lifting capacity of 400 tons or 880,000 pounds and can carry up to 12,000 tons or 26.4 million pounds of pipes on board. Saipem Constellation. The Saipem Constellation is another large pipelaying vessel in the world. It is owned by Saipem Group, an Italian-based offshore contractor. It was built in 2014 and converted from a drill ship. It has a length of 238 meters or 781 feet and a width of 42 meters or 138 feet. It can accommodate up to 700 people on board. It uses both J-lay and reel-lay methods and can lay pipes with diameters of up to 36 inches or 0.9 meters in water depths of up to 3,000 meters or 9,800 feet. It has a lifting capacity of 3,000 tons or 6.6 million pounds and can carry up to 10,000 tons or 22 million pounds of pipes on board. As you can see, the Saipem Constellation is like a giant drill on the sea. It can bore through the seabed and lay pipes with ease. Pioneering spirit. The Pioneering Spirit is the largest pipelaying vessel in the world. It is also owned by Allseas Group. It was built in 2016 and is the world's largest vessel by gross tonnage. It has a length of 382 meters or 1,253 feet and a width of 124 meters or 407 feet. It can accommodate up to 571 people on board. It uses the S-lay method and can lay pipes with diameters of up to 68 inches or 1.7 meters in water depths of up to 2,500 meters or 8,200 feet. It has a lifting capacity of 48,000 tons or 105.8 million pounds and can carry up to 27,000 tons or 59.5 million pounds of pipes on board. As you can see, the Pioneering Spirit is like a giant monster on the sea. It can swallow and spit out entire oil platforms in one go. These are some of the biggest pipelaying vessels in the world. They are marvels of engineering and technology that enable the construction of subsea infrastructure for the oil and gas industry. They are also vital for the development of renewable energy sources such as offshore wind farms and tidal power plants. They are truly the giants of the sea. I hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Also, don't forget to leave a comment below and let us know what you think about these pipelaying vessels. Which one is your favorite? Do you have any questions or suggestions for our next video? Let us know. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to get notified of our latest videos. Thank you for watching this video and see you next time.